Hey everybody, Clay Archer here, CEO, DPC Technology. Today I want to talk to you a little bit about the power of a good password. Passwords are a little bit of a touchy subject. Everybody knows they need to be stronger, but what does a good password really look like? What is a good password? How often should you change them? Do I need a separate password for everything? Where do I store all those passwords? These are the questions that everybody always asks me. Today I'm going to get into two tips for password security and ensuring you have your private data secure and safe. It may be good to start at the beginning. How are my passwords being compromised? The main way that your passwords are being compromised is by breaches on large websites. You hear them all the time, the MySpace, the Target, the Equifax, and so on, being compromised on the news. These large databases of patients or passwords are stolen and traded on the black market. If you regularly use the same passwords on multiple sites, any targeted attack on your identity becomes exponentially easier with this information. We use a dark web utility that monitors clients' domains and regularly finds common breach passwords on the dark web. The bad guys are able to see these passwords and use an automated process to try your compromised credentials on millions of sites. Think of Amazon, eBay, Wells Fargo, PayPal, financial institutions. The list goes on and on. So your passwords are out there, and how do you secure them? How do you shore up your security and ensure that your private data is safe? Well, we recommend a two-tiered approach. The first tier is to have a strong master password. To create a strong master password, we recommend a program called Diceware. It's not really a program, it's a website, it's a process. I'm sharing a link in the description below on how you can find a Diceware generator that you can use. But over the years, we have trained ourselves to use ever more complex passwords with symbols and letters that are less secure and harder for a human to remember. Think of it like maybe you use your mother's maiden name and the year you graduated college, and you'll substitute in an at for an A, or you'll put an exclamation point at the end of it. But those aren't very, they're not very random items. You think they're random items, but they're tied back to you. And so what the bad guys do is they'll use these combinations that they know that you're gonna use. And let's just say that you used your mom's maiden name in the year you graduated from college. They'll use different variations of that password that they find on the dark web day after day. So they'll try Amazon one day with just your password they find on the dark web, but then they may change a letter, they may add an exclamation point, they may change the descriptor a little bit, but they figure these things out and they can run it in an automated process. The problem with these is that these passwords are just not very secure at all. We think they are, but to a computer, they're not at all. A Diceware password, in contrast, uses dice rolls to randomly pick words from a set word list. The key is the true random nature of the words. In the case of the passwords that we pick, although it seems really random to us, it's actually quite predictable. The variations and number replacements that we use are also very predictable and give brute force attempts an easy starting point. Let's take a look at this example. This is a slide from our cybersecurity training that we do here at DPC Technology. You can see in the top left that the password is something that we would typically think is quite complex, with the capital letters and the numbers replacing letters and the symbols. But actually, this is a pretty easy password for a computer to crack. And also, it is quite hard for the person to remember this password. Did I replace that zero, or did I replace that O, or where did I put the letter, and where did I put the symbol? At the bottom, you can see correct horse battery staple is a Diceware password. And we go through this at the beginning of the seminar, and we go through this exercise of remembering it with this kind of pictorial image way of recognizing it, with the horse saying, that's a battery, and the guy saying, that's correct. Well, what's interesting about this is by the end of the seminar, almost everybody in the room can remember correct horse battery staple. And actually, to the computer that's trying to crack this, this is a much more complex password. Okay, so now you have a secure master password. How do you use it? The fact is, if you use the master password on a website and that website gets compromised, the bad guys are going to get your complex password, no matter how complex it is. The only way to avoid having your password used against you on multiple sites is to have separate, complex passwords for every website, every logon that you have. How is that humanly possible? And now on to the second tier. The second component is a good password manager. I personally use 1Password. The way it works is you use the master Diceware password that we just created to log on to the password manager. The password manager stores all of your passwords for every site, for every program, for every logon. What makes it so secure is the password manager can create a truly complex, unique password for every site, and you don't have to remember it. You then install the password manager app on all of your devices, and voila, you solved the issue. What's even better is you'll never have to create new passwords that you inevitably forget and or lose. If you're on a random computer, you just log on to the password manager portal and retrieve the complex password for each individual site. The password manager I use is around $3 a month, depending on whether you pay for it monthly or annually. Are you interested in learning if any of your passwords that you or your team uses are on the dark web? Check out the link in the description below to get started on a free dark web search today. Thanks so much for watching our video. If this information was useful to you, please give us a big thumbs up and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Don't miss out on our next videos. Please click the bell icon below so you can be notified when we upload our next video. As always, thanks so much for watching, and we'll catch you on the next video.